to see a new champion of the WWE crown.
Locally owned home center in North Texas. Why rent or lease to lose when you can own your dream home for less?
We can buy a new home just down the street for only $399 a month. What do you think of that?
I think it's too high. At Mega Homes, we blow the heck out of high prices. Call Mega Homes now where you buy the home and not the showroom. Mega Homes, where you will save mega money.
First match, a great crowd on hand. It's going to be an exciting night.
It's going to be terrific tonight. It's loud. Better hear ourselves think.
All right, looks like the referee's getting ready. You ready up in the ring? Let's go. All right, Tretch Phillips. Actually, this is Tretch Phillips Jr. His father was a great wrestler, and he is one of my all-time favorites. I've known this guy for quite a while, and he's got Tiger on the front of his tights, and that's what he is in the ring, a Tiger.
I want to enjoy this match. I've never seen this man work, but about his physique and the way he's built, it's going to be an excellent match.
He sure is. Now, this catch can, now you know more about him than I do. I've just heard good things about him, but yet he hadn't won a match.
No, not sure. He's 0-3 right now. He's a real methodical wrestler. He's a good wrestler, but for some reason, he hasn't got that first win yet.
Well, maybe he'll get it tonight, but I tell you what, now, like I told you, I've seen Tretch Phillips for a long time, and he can be very treacherous, but let me tell you, the guy can wrestle. And, I mean, he can get on the mat. He can wrestle for 20 or 30 minutes and never throw a punch or a kick. Just hold after hold if he wants to. He's that kind of technical.
He looks really good. He's built really good. You can tell you, he's no slouch. He works out in the ring at least, three or four times a week. He looks very good.
Exactly. Well, you guys have done a good job. I'm looking here at the card and seeing what all is coming up here in the WWA. And we've got a great card coming up. The Jacksons are going to be here. Livewire versus Eli. Johnny Mantell versus Vinny, one of the Bronx Bombers. Man!
It's going to be an excellent night. Yeah, the crowd's already getting Andrew Tiger. He's a favorite already.
That's it. And they're hollering Tiger. Covered elbow rock up, and Tretch takes him. And they just reverse right back and forth in that hammerlock.
Yeah, Cash could have been reversals. He knows the moves. Going to a full Nestle there.
All right. Here's Tretch with the reversal. He takes him right around in a reach around. Tretch takes him right down. They'll ride him. Look at Tretch go there in the middle of the ring wrestling. That's one of the things I'm so proud to be here, because I've heard that this is wrestling the way it's supposed to be, wrestling the way it used to be, and that's a credit to you and your organization.
Well, that's why I started WWA 4, is to have wrestling the way it's supposed to be. Two unarmed men in the middle of the ring fighting for supremacy. No, that's what WWA is for. It's for wrestling, not for weapons and things of that sort.
You shouldn't have to cover your kids' eyes at the wrestling matches.
Exactly. You should have to sit with a remote control in your hand watching television.
And you look around the crowd here ringside, there's so many kids, and they're just having a great time. Families are here from 8 to 80, from 4 to 40. They're all here.
Everybody's here. Well, there's everybody. It's terrific. This is a great night.
All right. Tretch Phillips and Catch Can right here on the WWA. Catch Can 0-3. Maybe tonight. There's a nice takeover by Tretch.
That's an excellent hip toss. That looked good. That was a good drop kick right into the ropes.
Catch Can doesn't want anymore, Tretch. That hip toss got him.
That's the first time I've seen Tretch worry, but I thought maybe Catch Can had a chance to win tonight. But I don't know now.
Like I said, he's a veteran. He's been in a lot of wars. I saw him, he broke a guy's neck in Mississippi about 4 years ago. He gave him a belly to back and just slammed him. So the young man is definitely a contender. And you know, I've heard about this scientific trophy match. Good move by Tretch. Reversal. Well, he turned that around. I was fixing to get all excited for Tretch.
I was fixing to jump up, but man. Now draw that head right down. Oh, good elbow.
Right to the throat. One, two. Two count. And Catch got out of that. Catch and Tretch.
Hey, I didn't even think about that. Right on top of us.
Oh, look at that. Beautiful spinning head toss. My goodness.
That was an excellent wrestling hold. I like seeing high flyers.
That's it. Well, you know, that's one of the things wrestling, so many other organizations and shows you see on TV, they go out and all it is a cartoon. There's no wrestling involved. I want to see two guys get on the mat and wrestle. One, two, he's going to get him. No, he did not. My goodness.
It was just right there. He almost had his first win.
Wow, that was very close right here this early in the match. Actually, he's got Tretch on the ropes right now. Tretch is breathing very hard. I look there and see his stomach, and you can tell that Tretch is hurting.
We don't know which one's younger, but you can't see what Catch looks like.
Well, now, I just saw him in the dressing room, and that's how he looked. He didn't even speak to me.
He hasn't spoke to me. He's worked for me.
He just gets his check.
Well, that's it. You know, he comes in, let's get paid, and he leaves.
Both guys are already pretty tired, and early on in the match they have gone at it. It's so hot and heavy here on the WWA. Tretch Phillips fighting back, another shot, an elbow to the side of the head. Oh, the proverbial eye ache right there. That slows Tretch down.
Yes, it did. It slowed him down bad.
Suplex. Oh, he went for the slingshot suplex, but it didn't take him over. He just hooked him right there on the ropes, and Tretch Phillips' midsection is in pain right here, right now.
That's definitely going to take the air out of you. You know, if you're trying to get a comeback, that happens, you're down for a while. So see, Cash should already been back on top of him instead of him messing with the crowd.
That's exactly right.
He should come over here and took care of him right then. Big forearm.
That's what you actually, a European uppercut. You've seen a lot of the guys in the years past. One, two, almost a three, but that big European uppercut, it's so dangerous. A lot of associations back in the 60s and 70s banned that shot. Could not do that.
I didn't know that.
I think about one of the great Johnny Eagles and some of the old, even I think of German Chris Adams with that big European uppercut.
I remember watching Chris Adams do it all the time. It was him. No, he did a uppercut and he did the spinning back kick. That was his major hold.
I've had the super kick upside the head. Oh my goodness! One, two, and Tretch got out of that. I thought that was a pinning shot right there for sure.
Good. That was a good hold. Cash Can knows a lot of holds. He's very good wrestler. But he just didn't get it there.
Well, Fans on the email say it's a lack of concentration why he doesn't win. And there he is again, fooling with the fans instead of getting on Tretch Phillips.
Big kick to the shoulder.
And by the way, folks, if you want to email us or talk to us, you can go to the web page. Ready? One, two, and he kicked out. He kicked out again.
They should have hooked that low. He was just kind of a nonchalant cover.
Anyway, the web page, www.wwa.nu.
That's right. You need me to make it myself out there, or you just leave some feedback, whatever you want to do. Big body slam.
We want to hear from you folks. We want to know what you think about the show. We want to know what you think about bringing wrestling back. And oh my goodness, he's got Tretch on the ground, and he's working the head. He's got one hand pushing down, one hand pulling up, and Tretch Phillips is in tremendous pain with the pressure being put on his head by Catch-Catch-Can.
That hold not only does it stretch your neck muscles, but it gets hold of your jaw, too. You put it all the way through your neck.
Clothesline as he comes out of the corner and Phillips goes down, but he's right back up. A kick to the gut. Oh, man. Both wrestlers are hurting pretty good. Nobody has been able to keep a clear advantage. One gets the advantage, the other one takes it away and takes it back. And Catch-Catch-Can, well, I was going to say, he slowed up too much.
He goes Tiger's coming back. Oh, that's fresh to the eyes. You know, Catch-Catch is a methodical wrestler, but he knows what to do to get back into it.
Folks, we're so glad you tuned in here on Super Kick to the Side of the Head. It was a short super kick. I don't think he got full extension, but it was enough to put Tretch Phillips on his back on that hard canvas mat. And I was checking that ring out earlier, and my goodness, that's a hard ring.
It's a very hard ring. You wouldn't throw him out of the ring.
It's not harder than that concrete floor, though.
No, that hard concrete floor is pretty bad.
See, here's a mistake. The young guy, he's going to show to the camera. He's going to play to the crowd. He needs to get Tretch Phillips back into the ring. He needs to do something right here.
10 minutes gone in the match.
And Tretch Phillips is in trouble right now as Catch-Catch-Can is on the verge of winning his first match right here on the WWA.
I hope he wins. I'd like to see him win, but I don't know. You know, Tretch is doing an excellent job against him, but it's been like, every time he gets the steam going back, Tretch gets to do something like gouging the eye or something like that. A big knee lift to the midsection right there off the rope.
Hey, folks, don't forget now, our next show is on January 29th at Rio Vista, the middle school gym in Rio Vista. Email us, sir. Hey, everybody, there's a low up. One, two. Kick out. He got out. It was so close. My goodness, how close can you get?
That was right there. I thought he had him.
Now, Tretch has him again.
Yeah. Two count on him.
My goodness, two quick pinfalls by Tretch Phillips. He's going to go for another one. And look, the wrestling move. And good move by the referee. You saw how he waited. The shoulders weren't down yet. And that's a good referee in the ring right there.
And here's the WWA. The referee takes care of takes charge of the matches.
Oh, my goodness. My goodness. A powerbomb from an X scissors. Down he goes. Here we look at here. One, two. And he really didn't get two. He kicked out. And Catch-Catch-Can again.
Raising his arm out. He didn't win the match. What you doing?
It was barely a two count. Look at Tretch. Beautiful. One, two, three. Tretch Phillips wins. Tretch Phillips wins right here on the WWA. Oh, my goodness.
What happened there? He just stopped for some reason. What happened?
It just happened so quick, like a bolt of lightning. Tretch Phillips came out of nowhere and beat Catch-Can-Can, who goes to 0-4. We'll take a break, and we'll be back. We're going to be talking to the Jacksons. We've got more matches coming up. We're going to meet a big Hillbilly Cousin Luke later in the show. So stay with us on the WWA.
Size of that fifth wheel. I mean, if it's there next to Johnny Mantell, you know what kind of man that is. That's 15 RV Center, Vital Rex, who picks you up with something you can spend a weekend, a week, a lifetime in. Right here, exit 415 between Fort Worth and Weatherford. Come see him off I-20.
Woo! We're here, man.
Hi, folks. I'm Brent Claiborne, owner of Mega Homes, the largest locally owned home center in North Texas. Why rent or lease to loot when you can own your dream home for less?
We can buy a new home just down the street for only $399 a month. What do you think of that?
I think it's too high. At Mega Homes, we blow the heck out of high prices. Call Mega Homes now where you buy the home and not the showroom. Mega Homes, where you will save mega money.
When we improperly dispose of motor oil, paint, and toxic household chemicals, some of it ends up in our water, in our lakes and rivers and oceans. So in the end, the bodies of water we pollute may someday be our own. Call this number to find out how you can safely dispose of water pollutants. Because we all have a stake in keeping our water clean. If we all do a little, we can do a lot.
Bored? Restless? Thinking about making a move? Then get moving.
Go above and beyond.
It's about experience.
It's yours for the taking.
Get it.
Air Force Reserve. Working together.
It's about contribution.
Making it happen.
Make it. It's about satisfaction.
Education.
Find it. Air Force Reserve. Above and beyond.
1-800-257-1212.
Thank you.
And Wallace, let's throw it up there right now. Here's our ring announcer, Dave Ambrose.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time I would like to introduce the gentleman in the ring. Weighing in at 260 pounds, who knows where, please welcome Eli.
Well, we're waiting on the arrival of his opponent. Oh, my goodness, here he comes. The music started up. I feel the tension. I feel the excitement.
What happens to Nice Talk? It's going to be live wire. You hear all the music?
Yeah. Let's don't spoil Dave's thunder now, Wallace. Right. Just catch you the boss.
That's true. I shouldn't have said anything just yet. Yelling for him. Well, they all want to touch his hand. They want to shake his hand, and it's just great.
He's got a Raleigh dude haircut.
Hey, Dad.
And the people are absolutely mobbing him. The crowd's excited, and again, I just can't tell you what the, oh my goodness, one of the greatest stars in the history of this sport has joined us at the table, ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only Iceman, King Parson. What brings you here tonight, my friend?
Oh man, I'm just checking it out, you understand? You know how it is, I'm looking for talent all over the country, you understand me? And right now, what I'm looking at, I don't know if this is what I need, you understand? I've noticed old boy over here.
That Eli fella?
Yeah, I know old Eli. Me and him go way back, you understand?
He's a tough cookie.
Oh, he's all right. But this thing here and that thing over there wannabe. He wannabe.
Well, now, I just got here. I've heard so much about this Night Stalker tag team. The people love him, man.
Yeah, I do too. Love to beat him up.
Ain't nothing changed. Ain't nothing changed.
Oh, no. It's all the same. Look.
All right, live wire in the ring with Eli. There's an elbow to the side of the arm, and Eli goes right for the ropes.
Oh, yeah, he's slick, though. You kind of got to watch him. He's a slick one. But these two here, they can't walk and chew bubblegum at the same time.
They just babies, huh?
That's all.
Well, you know, you young ones trying to climb the ranks.
Oh, yeah, but hey, when I come up young, I was whooping everything young and old.
That's true. I have to give you credit.
Often imitated, but never duplicated. Like Mama says, the bees that way sometimes.
Hammerlock in the middle of the ring. All right. And there's a crisscross.
Good drop kick.
Yes, indeed. Another drop kick. And Eli goes down and out of the ring. And Livewire is fired up out there. My goodness.
You can do better than that. He just got lucky.
Just got lucky.
Caught him with his back turned. That's all.
All right. Well, we'll see. Eli makes his way back into the ring now, and look at him. He's not too happy with the youngster.
Look at his boots. Got the skull and crossbones on the boots. I didn't even notice that.
That's right. Now, this is a very, very intimidating man. You look at Eli. It's like Iceman was saying earlier, for years I've seen this guy, Oklahoma, Texas, Alabama, Mississippi, all through the South, and he has devastated opponents. Look out. He missed, and Livewire's ready for him. And Eli goes right back to the corner.
That's what I'm talking about. That's the difference between a pro and a rookie. If anybody go down on me, boy, I'm going to keep him down. You understand? He had him, and then led him back up on his feet.
That's right.
He's in trouble now.
Rookie mistake, and Eli takes right back over.
He's in trouble now.
Eli runs his head into the corner. And Livewire goes down, his partner on the side of the ring trying to give encouragement. But right now, it's all Eli as he is taken over here on Livewire, right here on the WWA World Wrestling Alliance, right here on TV tonight. Oh, another shot, and a shot to the gut, and they're reversing back and forth. And here comes across the ring reversal, Eli in the corner, and Livewire with a splash in the corner. Knee to the gut, another knee to the gut, and Livewire's looking pretty good now, Ice.
Yeah, but watch this pro. See, that's what I'm talking about. He's a pro. He's a pro, brother. He's been around.
There's the pinfall, one and two count. Didn't get a three, and Eli's the
three. That's the problem. The referee can't count to three.
Well, Eli didn't appreciate the count.
That boy was beat, man. He was beat.
Things aren't looking good now for Livewire right here on the WWA. He's from the WWA Wrestling School, so you've known him from the beginning. Oh, my goodness. He's on the mat. One, two, and a kick out. Oh, that was close. That was so close.
Livewire's looking good tonight. He's going at it. He's not, though. When he's got the heat going, he's really going at it today, man. But this pro, he's got some stuff on him. Big time step flip. One.
Just a one count there. As the rookie gets up and catches a shot to the side of the head, and Eli now says, the heck with wrestling, I'm just going to take over on the young man.
Oh, he know what he's doing. He know what he's doing. He already knew he could whip this boy, or he wouldn't have signed the contract.
Well, Iceman's pretty sure of himself over here at the table, but that's part of being Iceman.
That's how Iceman keeps. He's always been that way. Big elbow to the chin.
There's a count now. One, two. Oh, my goodness. Just at the last second, he kicked out. Referee Sam Miller was right there on it, and that was so close.
Yeah, the referee, somebody pinned the referee.
There's a slam to the mat, and Eli goes down for another pinfall. One, two. Oh, my goodness. That was so close again. 2 and 99.99999 almost through.
A fraction of a second. That's all it was taken. That's all it took, you know, but he popped out of it.
They say close is only kidding with horseshoes and hand grenades. Oh, my God, a gut-wrench suplex over the side. And down goes the big man, Livewire. Two, three, oh, my goodness, again. And Eli's getting livid. He doesn't like it. The referee has not been able to get the three count. It's so close. That's three straight times. It's been a two and...
What you playing with him for, boy? Why you playing with him?
Oh, my goodness, right to the throat. And I do believe now we've seen pretty much the end of Livewire. I think Eli's playing with him, you're right.
But why are you playing with him? I beat him in 2 minutes. It's taking you a half an hour.
You think you can... 2 minutes?
I beat him in 2 minutes. It's taking him an hour.
A great veteran, Iceman King, pushes it. Again, almost three. My goodness, the resiliency of this young man.
He's staying in there. He's pumped up. This crowd's really got him pumped and going. He doesn't want to lose this match. He's not going to give in that easy.
Well, like we said, he's from the WWA Wrestling School, and I guess you've seen his heart and his character training at the school on a regular basis.
This man is very dedicated. He's dedicated all the way through.
Well, he's one of those folks, he and his partner, I've been hearing so much about all the way to the Hawaiian Islands about this team of the Night Stalkers, and they are definitely the team of the future.
They are. Yeah, you know, they're quick, clean wrestlers. They're out here for one reason, that's to win. They're going to do anything they can to win.
Well, things are kind of slowed down in the ring now as Eli's pretty much taken over.
I'm hungry. Have somebody bring us a pizza in here or something, because this here is boring. You dig? Raw bore me, man.
Eli's got the man pretty well beat, it looks like, and he's just toying with him.
Don't look like he's toying with him. Look like he got his hands full.
Oh! Look out! And there are the ropes! What a great job by Livewire to come back.
What you gonna do, boy? It gonna take you all night to whoop him? It gonna take you all night, boy? Huh? All night? Jesus.
And Iceman's living here. He thinks he should have already beat him. Takes him right over. There's a foot to the back, another foot to the back.
I used to like him, but I don't like him anymore.
You don't?
He done got worse, though. People improve. He done got worse. Instead of going up, he's going down.
The wrong way.
Yes, sir.
All right. Eli.
Not a speck of trouble.
You never had a loss to Rose, are you?
Oh, no, baby. Oh, no. My mama told me I should have been a poet, and I didn't even know it.
Lord have mercy.
Oh, it's such an honor to be sitting at the table with the great Iceman King.
You ain't doing nothing.
And Ice is getting livid over here.
Yeah, they're livid about it. Oh, what's he so upset about?
Well, he thinks he should have beat him. Ice says he could
have been over with long time ago, man.
Sticking in there tonight. Livewire's sticking in there, and he's fighting for this. You know, he wasn't going to win out of this.
Yeah, well, see, Ice is not giving Livewire a lot of credit. To Iceman, he's just a young jabroni.
I got a man in the back to take care of this sucker here.
What? Which one? Either one?
I know this. Super Dave will take care of this boy right here, man.
You really think so?
I know I got a man in the back of whoop him.
Come on. Oh, my goodness. There's a backbreaker. One, two. Oh, two count right there. Again, how close can you come? How many times?
He's dedicated now. He does not want to lose this match. He's doing everything he can to hang in there. Also, it's already his last getting beat on like this. But they just dominated him tonight. Livewire's staying in. Big elbow to the back of the neck.
And Eli is just dominating this young man. Livewire started the match out pretty good. He was rolling pretty good. But Eli's taking over and he missed. He missed. He went for a big elbow. And Livewire connects with the elbow. Eli's in trouble and Livewire's on fire.
Now look at him now. He should have it now if he played right.
There's a big shoulder tackle. Down goes Eli. And Livewire's going up high. Livewire's going to the top. Look at him. Oh, yes. A huge splash off the top rope. One, two, and a kick out. Eli kicked out of that.
I'll see how he got out of that. That was a big splash. Well, that's a high flying move.
I tell you what, I'm having so much fun here. What a great hour we're having on the WWE. He takes him over in a side suplex. And Livewire's going up high again. One more time, he's going up high.
I got a little heart. But for some reason, he just couldn't go 2 minutes with me.
And he missed. He missed. The brain of Eli, the experience, just took over. He went to the well one too many times, Ice.
Oh, it's all over now. It's all over.
There's that big drop. One, two, three. He got him. He got him. Wow. The winner.
Pull it out there for a minute. You know, but watch somebody high flying act.
Oh, what's going on over here? Iceman is having a chat with Eli.
I got a man in the back named Dave to take care of this chump.
Oh, he's a chump, man. Get Dave out here.
He's a chump.
Well, is that Dave in the ring?
What's Dave doing in the ring now?
Iceman is going to sucker Eli. Oh, my goodness. Iceman's talking about he's got a man in the back, and he doesn't realize it. Eli doesn't realize the man's behind him. Eli, you need to look behind you. Oh, my goodness. Iceman just slapped him upside the head. You better look out. There's a roll-up. Dave's in there. One, two. Did he get him? And Dave just beat him. Dave just beat him, Eli. Oh, my goodness. Eli with the knee. And there's a drop again on Dave. Oh, there you go. Let's see if he'll count that. One, two, three. Oh, my goodness. And Eli got back on Dave. 2-3-5-W-O. It is 3-5-W-O. My goodness, folks. We got a title match coming up next. I'm so excited.
I'm great. I can't wait to see this. It's going to be a great match.
Cowboy Johnny Mantell against Vinny and the Bronx Bombers. Hey, boy. Get him. Hey, boy. You got me next time. You got me next time.
But you got me next time,
sucker. The great Iceman King Parsons here ringside with us. We have a hand for the Iceman. Wow. Bringing Dave out to the ring. Hey, that was a great match.
That was a great match. I thought Live Wire was going to pull it out. Those offline moves and everything. He had the heart to stay in it.
Hey, stay with us. Stay with us, y'all. Coming up, Cowboy Johnny Mantell in a championship match right here on the WWE.
Claiborne, owner of Mega Homes, the largest locally owned home center in North Texas. Why rent or lease to lose when you can own your dream home for less?
We can buy a new home just down the street for only $399 a month. What do you think of that?
I think it's too high. At Mega Homes, we blow the heck out of high prices. Call Mega Homes now where you buy the home enough for showroom. Mega Homes, where you will save mega money.
Up here. I'll tell you what, WWA action is hot and heavy, folks. Don't forget, we're going to be at Rio Vista at the middle school gym on January 29th. What night of the week is that?
It's next Saturday, 2 weeks from Saturday night.
Saturday night, January 29th, Rio Vista Middle School Gym. I bet you can get some tickets too, right?
Oh, yeah. Give me a holler.
Give us a call at the office, and the number is, I'm going to let you do the plug-in.
The number is 817-297-7466 to the office.
I tell you what, I'm so excited to be here in the WWA. It's been a great hour, and it's going to get better and better and better. And here comes the champion right now. We're getting close to this introduction.
It's about time to get started.
All right. Well, the ring's pretty crowded. And I guess what we're going to do right now is throw it up to our ring announcer. Here's Dave Ambrose.
Ladies and gentlemen, this will be our TV main event of the evening. First, I'd like to introduce Cal of the Bronx Bombers, weighing in at 290 pounds from the Bronx, New York. Please welcome.
Check it out. out the belt in the middle of the ring. Referee Sam Miller's got it and showing it off to the Bronx Bombers.
Wait a minute.
Well, Vinny's already trying to take off with it. Look at that.
The match hadn't even started, and the guys already think they won the match. Let's get the championship belt right here on us. I think I might want to hold it for a little while, huh?
I wouldn't mind holding that around my belt, but go ahead, blow some Johnny right now.
All right. We need to get this thing started. Now, this guy, Benny, you know, I thought we were friends. I've known these guys for years. They've been a tag team all over the world. I've seen them wrestle in Europe. I've seen them wrestle in Asia. I've seen them wrestle in the South, in the North, in the East, in the West. And, you know, I thought we were friends at the beginning of the show. They kept treating me like a jabroni.
They were doing me the same way. I'm like, me?
See, man, you're the president.
Yeah, talk to me like that. Let's see what we can do about that. Let Johnny take care of the business for me in the ring.
Johnny's got him back into the corner, and a clean break by Johnny Mantell. And I like to see that. Johnny Mantell is such a technical wrestler. He can get on the mat, and he can hurt you. He can hurt you without ever throwing a punch. He can hurt you without ever kicking, gouging, or any of those illegal tactics.
Well, Johnny's, you know, he has a great amateur background. He wrestled amateur since he was 10 years old. Now he teaches amateur wrestling at McConaughey High School in McConaughey, Texas. You know, when it comes to wrestling, there's nobody better than Cowboy Johnny Mantell.
That's right. Hey, while we got a second, I want to thank our sponsors, Mega Homes, Exit 415 RV Center, the WWA Wrestling School where champions are born.
Exactly.
And Choice Homes. And folks, when you see these sponsors, patronize them and let them know how much you appreciate them supporting WWA Wrestling.
If you need a stereo, TV, anything like that, call Choice Homes. They'll take care of you.
And Benny's taking back over there. Beautiful leap over. And one of those bombers hits the ground.
He's over, Gino over here holding his bar on his trunk. That looks like a good shoulder tackle to me.
That sure did. That was clean, 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 clean. Now referee Sam Miller, see, young referee, he is doing a great job, but he gets distracted letting the two guys work him like that. He needs to keep his eye focused on the match and stay in control.
That's it.
There's a conspiracy here against the Bronx Bombers.
Conspiracy. Where'd you get conspiracy from?
Side headlock by Johnny Mantell in the middle of the ring on Vinny. Takes him right over. And there's a beautiful move by Vinny to counter Johnny, but he goes right back and takes him right back down and gets the heads. And they go right out again. Beautiful chain wrestling here in the middle of the ring.
Just a quick action. They're both going quick. I like this match. I like a lot of action. That's what the WWE is. More action, less talk.
That's right. You know, you watch 3 hours of wrestling on certain nights of the week, and they have about 18 minutes of wrestling and 3.5 hours of commercial.
Exactly. We're not that way here at the WWE. We're here for a reason. We're bringing wrestling back the way it's supposed to be, and that's what we're doing here in the ring tonight.
And it shows with the crowd. You know, I'm so tired of being embarrassed for our children to watch wrestling on TV. And tonight, we've got all the kids here. Everybody's having fun. The moms and dads are glad that they brought their kid to this WWA wrestling event. And you can bring your kids. We want to see you out here. The crowds are getting bigger and bigger, man.
Oh, this is unreal. This is great tonight. Big flip in.
That's right. And Johnny Mantell has control here in the standing room only. We're out of seats. Folks are standing everywhere. And they're enjoying this television main event for the WWF Heavyweight Championship, Cowboy Johnny Mantell and one of the Bronx Bombers, Vinny.
Johnny going to do a test of strength? No, Vinny going to back off from him.
He doesn't need to do power moves with this big guy. I tell you what, Vinny, 6'2", 290, he's big and strong. He can wrestle, but he can fight. And that's when he gets his best, when we start fighting. Johnny Mantell's at his best when we're wrestling.
Oh, what about that amateur move by Johnny was too quick for Vinny to watch him.
Exactly right. My goodness. And there's a big uppercut, and Vinny is scrambling right now.
He's going to keep this boy busy. He's going to stay on top of him for a while.
Hey, we talked about Rio Vista on January 29th at the middle school gym, y'all. Action Jackson will take on Cowboy Johnny Mantell or whoever is the champion at that time. Action Jackson will have a tighter shot. Major Payne and Super T. Iceman's going to be there. A lumberjack match. Eli, Al Jackson and a whole bunch of people at Rio Vista on January 29th in the middle school gym. Give us a call at 940-297-7466. Keep the calls coming in, y'all. Elbow misses, and Johnny Manziel takes him right out over the corner. And Vinny is going to hit the concrete floor on the outside. Did I give the wrong phone number? I did. Help me here. 817-297-7466.
That's right.
I'm a dummy. Just call me dummy.
Oh, no problem. No problem. We know it's correct by those.
And one of the things I wanted to tell you how much I enjoyed being here so far. I come in, I got my suit, everything, and you go, hey, man, perform around here. Wear your blue jeans, put a polo shirt on, let's relax, eat some popcorn, and enjoy some wrestling, just like it was when we were kids.
If you want a good announcer, get rid of this bozo, I'll come help you.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, he's a talker. That's all he is. He's a talker.
Mantell has Vinny in the corner. There's a shot to the head. A fist, another fist to the side of the head. And he's going to kick him. The front of the boot right there in the gut. And a kick, repeated kicks to the gut.
Big hip toss. Right. Big hip toss all the way across the ring.
And things have changed. The tide has turned right here on the WWA. We could see a new champion in the making. This is for all the Barbers right here on TV.
He tells his crowd doesn't like this, guys. They want for Johnny. When Billy's getting upper hand, the crowd's really getting into it.
And oh, he's setting him up for a pile driver. He hit him down. He got him down on the pile driver. This could be it. But Johnny Mantell is in the ropes. He's going to have to move him to the middle of the ring.
He's over here showboating. He should be on top of him getting the pin.
Exactly. Again, how many times do you see showboating? And there's a choke. You see over the far side of the ring.
What's going on? The referee just turned around and watch what's going on over there. No, Johnny, he's coming around, but you tell Johnny's a little groggy over there.
He sure is. Well, he's got two on one. There's a knee to the throat right here. And the referee's going to have to do something to take control of this match.
Vinny's been wrestling for a while. He takes advantage of that 4-5 count. There's a distracted referee, so Jimbo's got Johnny back here in the back over there.
Well, again, this young referee, and I call him young because he's still young, he does a great job. He works very hard to keep law and order, but there's still things for him to... like that.
No, they won't. He's an excellent referee, like you said. No, but these two veterans, the Boss Bombers, they know how to work that referee.
While we're talking about the referee, there's a huge backdrop, and Johnny Mantell is out on the mat. He came down hard. And I do believe Vinny is fixing to win this match. Well, no, a one kick out. And another one. One kick out.
I mean, he's not hooking his leg or anything. He needs to be more. Oh, I'm dumbfounded tonight. More aggressive with his roll with his pins right there.
I don't know. I'm kind of pettish to this. I'm a good friend of Johnny Mantell. I know he's my good friend, and I sure hope he doesn't lose this match tonight. I'm the heck with it. I'm for him. I'll just say it. No non-bias here. I'm for Johnny.
I like to say that. I like Johnny Mantell. He's an excellent friend of mine. But I guess I have to stay neutral.
Well, you're the president.
Right,
you write all the checks.
Right.
And look out. What a move by Johnny. What a great trick to take over. And Johnny Mantell has turned this match back around. But both men are down. Both men are hurting. Both men are windblown.
We got the count of 10 to get out. But Vinny got out first. He wore Johnny out. No, just moves a while ago.
Oh, he's going up.
That's a high-risk maneuver here.
He could connect. He missed. He missed the elbow. He came from the second rope with the elbow, and Mantell found something deep down inside and moved out of the way. And look out right now. Oh, my goodness. The double X handle to the back.
That's a good thing about Cowboy Johnny Mantell. He does not give up.
Oh, and out of the concrete floor he goes. Vinny, and look, he's distracting the referee. And Gino is attacking viciously on the floor, Johnny Mantell. This is two against one.
He's up here messing with the referee again, and the referee's not turning around and looking. He doesn't know what's going on outside the ring.
My goodness. And the young referee is being distracted by the veteran wrestler. The Bronx Bombers are doing what they have to do, working as a team. And you know, tag team wrestling. Now, we say in conspiracy against them. You got a problem with these guys?
I have a problem at all with these guys. I don't know what they're talking about. I have no idea.
I think they just want to be disagreeable. I think they want to be antisocial. I just think, dadgummit, they don't want to get along with us.
That's what it is. I totally agree with you.
But their actions in the ring, they're going to get what they deserve, I hope. Because people like that, when you act a certain way, when you cheat, you can't ever come out on top. In anything you ever do, you may come out in the short term, but in life, if you cheat, you're going to lose in the end.
Right.
And I hope that happens right here.
The losers never win. You may win the battle, but you're not going to win the war.
That's right. Johnny Manziel has him down. 1, 2, and we... We were seconds, just a second away from Johnny Manziel retaining the title right here. My goodness. Hey, check out our webpage now, www.wwa.nu. Email us. Oh, a huge female. And Johnny Manziel goes down. We want to hear from you. I'll tell you what. We want to hear from you. We have had such a good time here on this show tonight. What a match we've had.
Excellent match. Well, both the guys are down. They got a 10 count to get back up.
My goodness. Johnny Manziel is in trouble. Oh. This is crazy. And Johnny Manziel is alive. Look at that face. Look at that grit. Look at that determination. Johnny Manziel is on fire right here. And down he goes.
Great clothesline. They put the big boy in his back. Johnny's getting through the crowd. The crowd's pumping him back up.
The pride of Montague County. Johnny Manziel, the champion, is now in trouble. An eye rake. Into the ropes. Clothesline. Johnny's on his feet. It didn't put him down. What's happening now? Going for the hip toss. Johnny's reversed it. He's got him up. 1, 2, 3. Johnny Manziel wins and retains the title. Oh, my goodness. What is Gino doing? Look, coming into the ring. One of the biggest men in professional wrestling. From Hogwaller, Tennessee. Cowboy Johnny Manziel. Cowboy Johnny Manziel. Hey, guys. Hey.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner and still World Wrestling Alliance.
It is Rob Lollipop. You've seen that. Were you behind this wall? What were you doing in the ring? Don't worry about it.
What were you doing out there?
I wasn't doing nothing.
I was out here
with my partner just being moral support.
Well, I don't know about moral support there.
No, I didn't look like moral support. To me, it looked like hands-on support.
That's right. Well, they're a tag team. They work together as a team. And, you know, teamwork is a good thing, except in that kind of example.
That's right. They say winners never lose. I mean, cheaters never lose.
Okay, look. We're going to take a time out here. And coming up in a few minutes, we are going to meet Hillbilly Cousin Luke in just a couple of minutes, the biggest man in professional wrestling from Hogwaller, Tennessee. He just came in to help Cowboy Johnny Manziel. Stay with us. We're going to talk to Cousin Luke and talk about next week and everything right here on the WWA. Man, this is great.
Yeah.
I'm having a ball.
Me too. Be great.
Thank you.
Claiborne, owner of Mega Homes, the largest locally owned home center in North Texas. Why rent or lease to lose when you can own your dream home for less?
We can buy a new home just down the street for only $399 a month. What do you think of that?
I think it's too high. At Mega Homes, we blow the heck out of high prices. Call Mega Homes now when you buy the home and not the showroom. Mega Homes, where you will save mega money.
Oh my goodness, we've had a great hour here on the WWE. Have you seen what I'm going to talk?
Right here on television against one of the Bombers. We just got it working.